بسم الله. الإخوة الرؤساء الحضور في هذا اليوم العظيم.
In the name of Allah, dear brothers present today on this great day.
أيها الجموعة الإسلامية الحاضرة من كل قارات العالم في هذا المكان في كمبالا اليوم.
Muslims, masses and congregations coming to Kampala from all walks of life today.
نلتقي اليوم لنحيي ذكرى ميلاد النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
We are here today to commemorate and celebrate the birth of the Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him.
ومن حق كل البشرية أن تحتفل بهذا اليوم.
It is the right of mankind to celebrate this great day.
لأن محمد هو نبي لكل البشرية.
Because Muhammad is the prophet for all human beings, the prophet of all mankind.
فهو خاتم النبيين.
He is the seal of the prophet.
وأن الإسلام هو دين الله.
And the Islam faith is the faith of Allah.
وكل الرسل الذين قبل محمد هم على ملة الإسلام.
All prophets, all messengers that came before Muhammad are following the path and the faith of Islam.
كل من آمن بالله وبرسله فهو مسلم.
Anyone who believes in Allah, anyone who believes in his messengers is a Muslim.
ومحمد كان خاتم هذه الرسالات الإسلامية.
Muhammad was the seal, the last one of these messages.
الله أراد للبشرية أن تكون في النهاية في دين واحد وهو دين الإسلام.
Allah wanted mankind, the human beings, to have one faith in the end, that is namely the faith of Islam, the faith of Muhammad.
فمحمد أرسل لكل البشر.
So Muhammad was sent to all of us, to all mankind.
خلافا لكل الرسل الذين قبله.
Contrary to messengers who were sent before him.
الذين أرسلوا إلى أقوامهم وقبائلهم، أما محمد أرسل لكل البشرية.
Muhammad was sent to all human beings, to all mankind. But messengers and prophets before him, they were sent to their own tribes, to their own people, to their own fellow men.
والله يقول إن الدين عند الله الإسلام.
And Allah says that Allah's faith is Islam.
ويقول أيضا ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه.
And he also says Allah that anyone wishes to have another faith apart from Islam will not be accepted from him.
وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين.
And in the end he will be a loser.
القرآن الذي بين أيدينا الآن هو الكتاب الوحيد المنزل من الله.
The Quran that we have now before our hands is the only book that is sent to us by Allah.
نحن نؤمن بالتوراة وبالإنجيل.
We believe in the Bible as well as we believe in the Torah.
ولكن البايبل موجود الآن غير البايبل اللي أنزله الله على 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 عيسى.
But the Bible or the holy book that we have now is not the Bible that was sent or revealed to Allah to Jesus.
والعهد القديم ليس هو التوراة التي أنزلها الله على موسى.
And the Old Testament is not the Torah that was revealed and sent to Allah to Moses.
والدليل على ذلك أن محمد كنبي خاتم النبيين مذكور في التوراة وفي الإنجيل.
And the evidence of that, the proof of that, that Muhammad as a prophet and being the seal of the prophet is mentioned in both the Bible and the Torah.
ولكن الإنجيل الموجود الآن، التوراة الموجود الآن، لا نجد فيها ذكر محمد.
But the Torah that we have right now and the Bible that we have right now, there is no mention of the Prophet Muhammad.
معناها هذه مزورة.
This means that it has been frauded.
لأن موسى عليه السلام قال لهم إن سيأتي نبي اسمه محمد.
Because Moses, may be peace upon him, told them that after him a prophet would come and under the name of Muhammad.
عيسى قال لبني إسرائيل إن أبشركم بأن سيأتي بعد نبي اسمه أحمد.
And Jesus also told the son of Israel that I heralded to you that after me a prophet would come by the name of Ahmed.
أي توراة وأي إنجيل غير مذكور فيه اسم محمد هو مزور.
So any Bible or any Torah that does not mention the name of Muhammad, then it is not true. It has been forged.
عيسى مذكور في القرآن 25 مرة.
Jesus is mentioned in the Quran 25 times.
لا نستطيع أن نشطب ولا عدد من هذه الأعداد المذكور فيها عيسى عليه السلام.
And being mentioned in the Quran 25 times, we cannot cross one mention of Jesus, may peace be upon him, in the Quran.
موسى مذكور في القرآن 138 مرة.
Moses is mentioned in the Quran 138 times.
ما نقدروش نشطب ولا على عدد من هذه الأعداد.
We cannot cross one mention of Moses in the Quran.
مريم مذكورة 39 مرة في القرآن.
Mary is mentioned 38 times in the Quran.
وكلها تقديس وتمجيد لهؤلاء الرسل.
And the mentioning of these messengers in the Quran is glorified and been highly respected and held in the highest esteem.
ونحن ما لم نؤمن ب إذا لا نؤمن بعيسى وبموسى ما نكون مسلمين.
And we cannot be Muslims unless we believe in Jesus, unless we believe in Moses.
لأن هذا مذكور في القرآن.
Because this is mentioned in the Quran.
إذن القرآن هو كتاب الصحيح اللي لم تشطب منه ولا كلمة.
So the Quran is the right book that nothing has been deleted out of it or removed.
علينا أن نبحث عن التوراة التي أنزلها الله على موسى والإنجيل الذي أنزله الله على عيسى، لكن أين هي الآن؟
We have to look for the Torah that was revealed or sent to Allah to Moses, as well as looking for the Bible that was revealed and sent by Allah to Jesus. Maybe peace be upon them. But where can find them? Where are they right now?
للأسف يبدو أن الكتاب المقدس الحقيقي قد أعدم. وهذا الموجود الآن بيننا هو مكتوب من البشر ومشطوب منه ما هو مشطوب.
Unfortunately, the real book that was sent, or the holy book that was sent by Allah, was written by human beings and it was forged, and we cannot find the real book right now.
محمد ولد في 13 من شهر بالتقويم الشمسي من شهر 4، شهر الطير، شهر ابريل، شهر نيسان، كل واحد يسميه، عام 571 بالتقريب لميلاد المسيح عليه السلام.
The Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, was born on the 13th of April in the year 571. He lived for almost 63
years.
This means that he died on the year 634.
من ميلاد المسيح عليه السلام.
After the birth of Jesus, may peace be upon him.
نحن الآن نورخ بمولد عيسى.
Now we date by the death of Jesus.
لماذا؟
Why?
لأن ميلاد عيسى عليه السلام كان معجزة، آية من آيات الله.
Because the birth of Jesus, may peace be upon him, was a miracle. Was a sign of Allah.
وفي القرآن مذكور بالتفصيل هذا الحدث هذه المعجزة هذه الآية.
In the Quran it is explained in details this miracle and this great event of the birth of Jesus.
يعني عيسى ولد بنفخة من الله بدون أب.
Jesus was born without a father by the Spirit of Allah.
وهذه معجزة.
This is in itself is a miracle.
آية من آيات الله.
And a sign, one signs of the many signs of Allah.
وعيسى كلم الناس وهو في المهد.
And Jesus spoke to the people when he was a baby in the cradle.
ويحيي الموتى بإذن الله.
And he was able to bring people back to life with the will of Allah or with the grace of Allah.
ويشفي المرضى بإذن الله.
And he was also able to make people recover from illness by the will and the grace of Allah.
ويصنع من الطين على هيئة طير وينفخ فيه يصبح طيرا بإذن الله.
He was also able to make things out of the birds in the shape of birds and make them fly or alive by the will of Allah.
ويطلب من الله أن ينزل عليهم مائدة من السماء فنزلت المائدة من السماء.
And he can ask Allah to send them a feast or a table of feast and that was done by Allah and it was sent to them from heaven.
هذه المعجزة من حقنا أن نورخ بها.
This is a miracle and it is our right to date by this miracle.
فالآن مرت 2007 سنوات على حدوث هذه المعجزة.
Now 2007 years have already passed since the inception of this miracle.
لكن هناك حدث آخر من حق العالم أن يورخ به.
But there is another event and I think it is within the right of the world to use it as a date, to date by this event.
وهو وفاة محمد عليه السلام.
Namely the death of Muhammad may peace be upon him.
لماذا؟
Why do we date?
لأن محمد هو خاتم النبيين.
Because Muhammad is the seal of the prophet, the last of the prophet.
لابد أن البشرية أن تؤرخ بوفاة هذا النبي متى توفي. النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
It is only right that mankind and human beings date by the death of this prophet being the seal of the prophet the day he died.
لأن هذا حدث مهم جدا.
Because this is a very important and significant event.
لأنه بوفاة محمد.
Because by the death of Muhammad
انقطع الاتصال بين السماء والأرض.
No more contact between heavens and earth.
توقف الوحي نهائيا بعد
No more revelation once and for all.
ولن يأتي رسول بعد محمد إطلاقا إلى يوم القيامة.
No more messenger, no more prophets after Muhammad at all.
ومن وفاة محمد قد صمتت السماء.
So since the death of the prophet, the heaven or the sky has become silent.
ولم ينزل أي وحي على الأرض.
And no more revelation sent to earth from heaven.
انتظارا إلى يوم القيامة.
And this will be the case till the last day, till the doomsday.
هذا آخر نبي.
Muhammad is the last prophet.
القرآن ذا آخر.
And the Quran is the last book.
القرآن ذا آخر كتاب سماوي.
And the Quran is the last divine book.
إذن من حق العالم أن يؤرخ بهذا اليوم.
So hence it is only right for the world or the mankind to use this date as a dating process.
يعني إذا محمد ولد عام 571 أو 570 بعد ميلاد عيسى عليه السلام.
We all know that the Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, was born in the year 571 after the birth of Jesus, may also be peace upon him.
طبعا نحن نحتفل اليوم بالثاني عشر من ربيع هذا بالقمري هذا التاريخ
Of course, we all know that today we are celebrating the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. That is the lunar system or lunar month.
يعني اليوم هذا اليوم الذي ولد فيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بالتاريخ القمري.
Yes. This is the day that the Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, was born by the lunar month.
لكن بالتقويم الشمسي هو ولد في شهر طير.
But with the solar system or the solar month, he was born in April, the month of April.
هذا اليوم هو يوم غير عادي في تاريخ البشرية.
This is a very important day, an abnormal day in the history of mankind.
لأنه هو نفس اليوم الذي ولد فيه محمد ومات فيه أيضا.
Because it is the same day, on this the same day, Muhammad was born and Muhammad was Muhammad died.
بعد 63 سنة.
After 63 years of his birth.
إذن لما نجمع 571 أو 70 على 63 الرقم اللي يطلع نطرحه من ميلاد عيسى يطلع وفاة محمد.
So the year or the number 571 or 570, if it is deducted minus 63 of the birth of Jesus, then we'll find the number will be the death of the Prophet Muhammad, or the years since he died.
يعني معناها محمد توفي عام 634 من ميلاد بعد ميلاد المسيح عليه السلام.
This means that the Prophet Muhammad died 643 years or 34 years after the birth of Jesus, may peace be upon him.
والذي لا يؤرخ بميلاد عيسى وبوفاة محمد خاتم النبيين يعتبر إذا كان من جانبنا احنا يعتبر متعصب ومعادي لأنبياء الله.
So anyone who does not use the date of the birth of Jesus or for dating or the date of the death of the Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, as far as we're concerned, he will be some sort of a fanatic person and taking a hostile position against Allah or against the...
لماذا لا يؤرخ العالم بوفاة آخر نبي؟
Why doesn't the world use the death of the last prophet as a dating process?
معناها العالم متعصب.
This means that the world is fanatic or being bigot.
تتحكم فيه نظرية الكراهية.
And controlled by the theory of hatred.
معناها العالم عنصري.
This means that is the world racist.
لماذا نحن نؤرخ بميلاد عيسى؟
Why do we use the birth of Jesus in our dating?
لأن هذا اليوم يوم غير عادي.
Because it is not a normal day. This day is not being a normal day.
ولد فيه نبي الله بدون أب.
That a prophet sent by Allah was born on this day without a father.
موسى عنده معجزات.
Moses has
آيات.
Had his own miracles, his own signs.
عنده عصا سحرية.
He has a magic wand or a magic stick.
وإذا ضم يده إلى جناحه تخرج بيضاء.
And if he put his hand or his arm under his armpit, it will be white or shining of light.
أنا بنبه إلى شيء مهم بهذا الخصوص.
I would like to caution about something important regarding this issue.
هناك كتب وأدعياء وأقاويل تتكلم عن معجزات محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
There are you know, literature or books on saying, talking about miracles of Muhammad, may peace be upon him.
لماذا؟
Why?
لأنهم شايفين أن عيسى عنده معجزات, موسى عنده معجزات, بيقولوا كيف محمد ما يكونش عنده معجزات؟
Because they see Jesus has or had miracles and Moses had miracles and they say how come that the Prophet Muhammad doesn't have his own miracles similar to the
هذا الله أرادك.
Allah wanted that. Allah decreed like that.
إحنا نؤمن بمحمد بدون معجزات.
We believe in Muhammad without miracles.
اللي بيخلق معجزات ينصبها لمحمد لكي يؤمن به هذا غير مؤمن بمحمد.
Anyone who creates miracles so that he can believe in Muhammad, actually, as a matter of fact, he doesn't believe in Muhammad.
هذا إيمانهم ضعيف جدا.
His belief is very weak in Muhammad.
كل الشيوخ والفقهاء والمتحدثين الذين يدعون أن هناك معجزات عند محمد هم غير مؤمنين.
All those people, the sheikhs and the preachers or the scholars who may claim that there are miracles Muhammad had, actually they are not real believers.
محمد يكفي أنه نزل عليه القرآن.
Muhammad, it's enough for him that the Quran was revealed to him.
هذا يكفي بدون أي معجزة.
The Quran is enough without any other miracle.
إذا ما بتؤمن بالقرآن اللي إذا كان فيه معجزات أخرى إذا أنت مش مؤمن حتى بالقرآن.
If you only want to believe in the Quran and you're looking for other miracles so that you can believe in the Quran, then you don't even your belief in the Quran is not that strong. Or
يكفي أن محمد خاتم النبيين.
It's enough for Muhammad that he is or he was the seal of the Prophet.
هذا شيء غير موجود عند أي نبي آخر.
No such a thing being the seal of the Prophet. I mean, was did not have it. No other Prophet or no other messenger had it.
في القرآن لا يوجد ذكر أي نبي صلى الله عليه وملائكته إلا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
In the Quran, there is no mention apart from the Prophet Muhammad, who Allah and the Malaika greeted and prayed upon him. Only Muhammad.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى وملائكته يصلون على محمد.
Allah and angels greet and pray for Muhammad.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
The verse says that in the Quran that Allah and the Prophet pray and greet Muhammad. So all believers do the same. May peace be upon him.
أنتم تقولون اللهم صل على محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم هذا خطأ غير صحيح.
When you say that Allah please pray upon Muhammad in the same way that you did on Abraham, this is not true actually. This is not correct.
الله لم يصلي على إبراهيم.
Allah did not pray for Abraham or did not greet Abraham in this way.
إبراهيم عليه السلام فقط.
We say Abraham may peace be upon him.
أما محمد فقط هو الذي صلى عليه الله وملائكته.
But it's only Muhammad that Allah and together with the angels صلوا عليه or prayed on him or greeted him.
أرجو أن توقف هذه الترهات التي تنسب إلى النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
We should stop that. We should check that and we should not relate or connect these falsehood that is connected to Muhammad.
إن خاطبه إن كلمته الغزالة. وخاطبه الجماد وخرج الماء من بين يديه وأنه أطعم ألف شخص من
that there are so many stories
that
a gazal maybe spoke to him or that he was able to feed 1,000 people or that he was able to do this and that. No, this is not true.
الذي يدعي هذه الأشياء هذا غير مؤمن بمحمد أصلا.
Anyone who claims that Muhammad was able to do these things I've just mentioned, he doesn't really believe in Muhammad.
Or that
the moon was divided because of the sake of Muhammad or Hussein.
هذا في القرن السادس الميلادي والقرن السابع الميلادي هذا تاريخ قريب لم ينشق فيه القمر إلى قسمين.
This is mentioned in the 6th century and 7th centuries and no moon was divided into two parts at the time.
من أين أتت هذه الترهات؟
Where these falsehoods come from?
هذا من ضعفاء الإيمان.
Only of those believers who are not, who have weak beliefs, actually fabricated such stories.
هذه ادعاء هذه المعجزات مناسبة للنبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
To fabricate these miracles and to make them up and say that Muhammad, may peace upon him, actually brought these miracles.
هذا بدل على أن هؤلاء الناس غير مؤمنين.
Proves that these people who claim that are not believers.
ويزعزع إيمان المؤمنين الآخرين.
And actually shake the belief of other believers.
كيف تقولون أن القمر انشق نصفين؟
How do you say that the moon was divided and Muhammad was able to do that, or it is connected or related to Muhammad?
الله يفعل هذا ولكنه لم يعمل هذا في.
Allah can do that, but he never did it.
في تلك الفترة.
He never did it at the time.
لأن موسى ضرب بعصاه الحجر فانفلق الحجر وخرج منه الماء راحوا يلفون أن حتى محمد خرجت بين يديه لم يحصل هذا.
You see, because Moses, Allah gave him the miracle when he hit the rock and 12 springs of water came out of this rock. They started making stories and said Muhammad was able also to get this water out of the land or anything. Actually, such a story never happened. It's not true.
هو النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو اللي قال لنا عيسى عنده هذه المعجزات وموسى عنده هذه المعجزات.
Actually, Muhammad, may peace be upon him, told us about the miracles of Jesus and the miracles of Moses.
لماذا لم يغار ويقول أنا ليس لدي هذه المعجزات؟ لماذا أنا ليس لدي هذه المعجزات؟
Why wasn't Muhammad jealous and said, how come that I don't have miracles like them?
هو نبي، هو عارف نفسه أنه نبي.
He's a prophet and he knew, he was sure of himself that he was a prophet sent by Allah.
والمعجزات هذه تخص الله ما تخصش هو.
And the miracles, this is the concern or the business of Allah. It's nothing to do with Muhammad, whether he has had miracle or not.
محمد لم يشهد علينا، لم ينكر أن موسى عنده عصا سحرية وفلق البحر وفلق الصخر.
Actually, Muhammad did not deny that Moses had miracles and he had the stick and he can do miracles by hitting the land or to come water out of it or.
وأن عصاه تتحول إلى حية تلتقط الحبال والحصير في الصحراء.
Stick can become live and can become a snake and gullible other sticks of other magicians.
محمد هو الذي قال لنا هذا عن طريق الوحي الذي جاء عن طريق.
Muhammad told us, man. Muhammad was told this by the revelation of Allah.
لماذا لم ينكر هذا الشيء؟
He never denied that. Why didn't he deny it?
هو قال لنا أن جبريل قال لي كذا وكذا وكذا.
He actually told us that Jibril told him the story, this, that.
وكتبه في القرآن.
And it was, and he wrote it. It was written in the Quran.
25 مرة والقرآن يذكر في عيسى.
25 times and the Quran mentions Moses or Jesus.
محمد هو اللي قال لنا أن عيسى يحيي الموتى بإذن الله.
Muhammad actually is the one who told us that Isa can bring back to life the dead or can make the sick people not sick anymore.
لأن الله قال له هذا.
Because Muhammad was told by Allah that.
ما يقدرش محمد يغير هذا.
So Muhammad could not change the story told to him by Allah.
لماذا محمد لا يغار ويقول كيف عيسى عنده هذه المعجزات وأنا ما عندي هذه المعجزات؟
So why didn't Muhammad become jealous and told that how come that I have no miracles?
هذه تخص الله الآيات.
This is the concern of Allah.
ومحمد مؤمن بها تماما.
And Muhammad of course believed in that 100%.
مؤمن بآيات عيسى وبآيات موسى.
And believed in the miracles or the signs of Jesus and the signs of Moses. He never doubted.
هو الذي قال لنا عنها.
And he's the one who declared that. We never knew it. Only knew it through Muhammad.
لأن جبريل قال له هذا.
Because Jibril told him that. The angel Jibril.
وكتبها في هذا المصحف الذي أصبح قرآن.
And he wrote it in this book that has become our Quran.
أرجو أن توقف هذه الترهات التي تنسب للنبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
I do hope that from this day, no more falsehood, no more fabrications related to Muhammad regarding miracles or signs. No.
ومحمد هو خاتم النبيين
محمد.
هذا شيء لم يعطى لأي نبي آخر.
محمد is the seal and the last prophet, and such a thing never happened to any prophet before him.
والله وملائكته صلوا على محمد فقط.
And Allah and angels يصلوا pray for Muhammad only. He's the only prophet.
كل الأنبياء يقول الله يقول عليهم السلام.
All
أما prophets. محمد قال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي.
When Allah mentions other prophets and missions, he say, peace be upon them. But when he mentions Muhammad, Allah said in the Quran that him and the angels actually يصلوا عليه, pray for him or greet him.
الله أسرى بمحمد من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى.
Allah أسرى and sent Muhammad by night from the Masjid Haram, the holy mosque, to the other mosque in Jerusalem.
هذه معجزة حقيقة.
This in itself is a miracle.
حقيقة هذه.
And this is a fact.
وأراها الآيات الكبرى.
And Allah showed great signs to Muhammad.
ولقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى.
And this is mentioned in the Quran. It says that Muhammad saw so many signs of Allah, great signs.
إلى غاية سدرة المنتهى الذي يغشى السدرة ما يغشاه.
Till he went to the holy seat of Allah. And what is the holy seat? It is all mentioned in the Quran.
هذه معجزات.
These are miracles.
وآيات بينات.
These are clear-cut signs.
وباهرات.
And shining signs.
ومذكورة في القرآن.
Mentioned in the Quran.
وقالها محمد.
And Muhammad actually revealed it and said it.
هذه تكفي. هذه معجزات.
This is in itself is enough. These miracles are enough for Muhammad.
أما نسب لمحمد أشياء.
But
ليست له.
To attribute Muhammad
things
to Muhammad that Muhammad actually did not bring or did not say, this is in itself is infidelity.
الآن الدجالون يضخون في شبكة المعلومات الدولية الإنترنت معلومات من هذا القبيل. هذه تخلق بلبلة في أذهان ال.
Now those silly people and they make such stories in the internet and in the websites, and actually it is misleading people. It's not true.
هذا هو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي نحن نحتفل بمولده هذا اليوم.
This is the Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, whom we celebrate his birth today.
هذا خاتم النبيين.
The last of the Prophet, the seal of the Prophet.
هذا نبي كل البشر.
The Prophet of all mankind.
الذين يهاجمون محمد في اسكندنافيا هم يهاجمون نبي مرسل إليهم هم أيضا.
Those people in the Scandinavian that they attack or smear the Prophet Muhammad, actually they are also attacking and smearing the same Prophet that was sent to them, meant to be their Prophet also.
الذين يهاجمون محمد هم جهلة.
Those people attacking and distorting the image of Muhammad are ignorant.
هم مرضى.
They are sick.
حاقدين عنصريين.
They are racist. They begrudge.
ضد الإنسانية.
They are against mankind.
ضد الله.
They are against Allah.
ضد عيسى.
They are against Jesus.
ضد موسى.
Against Moses.
لأن عيسى مؤمن بمحمد وموسى مؤمن بمحمد.
Because Moses believes in Muhammad and Jesus believes in Muhammad.
ومحمد مؤمن بموسى وبعيسى.
And Muhammad vice versa believes in both of them.
هل اسكندنافيا مؤمن بعيسى أبدا؟
Scandinavia believing in Jesus? No.
ما دام تهاجم محمد إذن هي كافرة.
Since they are attacking Muhammad, then it is infidelity. This is infidel.
هم يهاجمون نبي الله.
They are attacking or saying bad things about the Prophet of Allah.
الله سيحاسبهم.
Allah will judge them.
هم يعتقدوا أن محمد هذا نبي العرب.
They believe that the Prophet Muhammad is the Prophet of the Arabs only.
محمد نبي العرب وغير العرب.
But the Prophet of Muhammad is the Prophet of the Arabs and non-Arabs together.
وسكان اسكندنافيا محمد مرسل اليهم رغم انفهم.
And the inhabitants or the people of Scandinavia, the prophet Muhammad is sent to them, meant to be their prophet despite their will, whether they like it or not.
والله اكد ان دين محمد سينتصر.
And Allah stressed and assured that the faith of Muhammad will emerge victorious and will be victorious.
ولو كره المشركون.
And even if the non-believers don't like that.
سينتصر دين محمد ولو كره الاسكندنافيون.
The faith of Muhammad will be victorious even if the Scandinavians don't like it.
الله يقول
Allah says
يقول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل.
Allah says this illiterate prophet that is mentioned in their Bible and mentioned in the Torah. They find it mentioned in their books.
لكن التوراة والإنجيل اللي موجودة الآن مش مكتوب فيها الكلام هذا.
But the nowadays Torah and Bibles, we find no mention of the Muhammad.
إذا هي مصورة ليست التوراة الحقيقية
وليست الإنجيل. It's not the real Torah. It's not the real Bible.
وليس الإنجيل الحقيقي.
And it's not the real Bible either.
وإذ قال عيسى ابن مريم
also
يا بني إسرائيل
says,
يا بني إسرائيل إني رسول الله إليكم.
Also in the Quran, Jesus says to the sons of Israel, I am a prophet or a messenger sent to you.
مصدق لما بين يدي من التوراة.
Believing or authenticating what I have before my hands, the Torah.
ومبشرا برسول ياتي من بعدي اسمه أحمد.
And heralding that a messenger will come after me by the name of Ahmed.
تكلمنا في المرة السابقة عن الحج في تمبوكتو.
Last time in Tombuctu.
ونحن نحتفل بالمولد النبوي الشريف.
Also on celebrating the prophet of the birth of the prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him. We mentioned and we talked about الحج pilgrimage.
الحج موجود من قبل محمد.
Pilgrimage or حج was a practice before Muhammad.
من عهد إبراهيم وإسماعيل وقبله.
Since the days of Ismail and Ibrahim.
يعني مكة الكعبة.
مكة at the time and
موجودة قبل إبراهيم وقبل إسماعيل.
And the Kaaba was there before Abraham and before his son Ismail.
لماذا؟
Why?
لكي يحج إليها الناس.
So that people can go there for pilgrimages.
أي ناس؟
Anyone.
لا أي
all,
ناس.
All, what people can go there for pilgrimage?
ليس الذين آمنوا بمحمد فقط.
Not those people who believe in Muhammad only.
الحج موجود قبل محمد.
The Hajj or the pilgrimage was there before Muhammad.
الحج مفروض على كل الناس.
It is a practice that is imposed upon everybody that should do.
ماذا يقول القرآن في هذا؟ الله ماذا يقول في هذا؟
What does Allah say regarding this notion or this concept of pilgrimage and Hajj?
ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا.
In the Quran there is a verse Allah says that Allah asks people to go to Hajj if they have a feasibility of that, if it is possible for them.
قال على الناس ما قالش على العرب والمسلمين.
Allah says to the whole people, to the whole mankind. He is not talking to the Arabs or to certain people only to go to pilgrimage.
كل الناس مطلوب منهم ان يحجوا.
All people are required to do the pilgrimage.
من امريكا من اوروبا from من امريكا
from
من
Europe,
اسيا
from
افريقيا
Asia, from Africa, everybody is entitled to do that.
لان الكعبة اول بيت خلقه الله لعبادته فوق الارض.
Because the Kaaba was the first house created by Allah for worship.
إن أول بيت وضع للناس.
This is mentioned in the Quran that the first house for worship for mankind, for human beings, for people.
الله يقول وضع للناس ما قال وضع للعرب أو وضع للناس.
Allah says this house was was built or constructed for mankind, not for the Arabs, not for certain people or certain tribe.
هذا بيت الله فوق الأرض.
This is the house of Allah on earth.
لكل الناس.
For all mankind, for all peoples.
ومن واجب كل الناس أن تطوف حول الكعبة.
So it is the right or the duty for all people to go around the Kaaba.
وبين الصفا والمروة.
And to have the to go between the Safa and Marwa.
وأن تقف على جبل عرفات.
And to stand on the Mount of Arafat.
من الذي قال أن هذا حكر لمجموعة فقط من الناس؟
Who has told us that this should be done only by certain people?
من الذي قال أن الحج للذين آمنوا بمحمد فقط؟
Who has said that pilgrimage or Hajj only for those people who have believed in Muhammad?
هذا البيت وضع لكل الناس.
This is a house for worship that is constructed for all mankind, for all peoples.
هذا بيت الله ليس بيت أحد.
This is the house of Allah. This is not the house. This is nobody's house.
من يمنع الناس من يطوفوا حول البيت؟
Who can prevent anybody to go around the Kaaba, around this house?
ماذا يقول فيه الله؟
Let's say what Allah says in this regard.
إن الذين كفروا.
Those who are non-believers,
ويصدون عن سبيل الله,
those who do their best so that others cannot be believers,
والمسجد الحرام,
those who prevent people from going to the holy mosque,
الذي جعلناه للناس سواء,
the holy mosque that has been made equal to everybody.
الله يقول هنا,
Allah says this,
بآيات بينات,
Allah says this in clear verses.
قال إنك الكعبة هذه وضعتها لكل الناس.
That the Kaaba I have already made it for everybody.
كل الناس سواسية.
All peoples are equals للكعبة. To do the pilgrimage to go to Kaaba.
الله يقول من يمنع الناس من الحج للكعبة؟
God and Allah says who can prevent people from going to Hajj, going to pilgrimage, going to see the Kaaba?
الكفار فقط.
Only infidels or the non-believers.
إن الذين كفروا ويصدون عن سبيل الله والمسجد الحرام الذي وضعناه للناس سواء.
Those who do that are the non-believers and prevent people from going to the holy mosque who has already been made equally for everybody.
من أين العرب أنهم يحتكروا الكعبة بيت الله؟
How come that the Arabs monopolize the Kaaba, which is the seat of Allah or the holy place of Allah or the house of Allah?
حق كل الناس أن تطوف حول الكعبة.
It is the right of everybody to go around كعبة.
من أين جت تحريم غير اتباع محمد من الطواف على الكعبة؟
I don't know how come I don't know where the notion came that the non-believers or the non-followers of Muhammad have no right to go there or to go around the كعبة.
ليس هناك إلا آية واحدة في القرآن تتحدث عن هذا.
There is only one verse in the Quran which deals with this matter.
وهي واضحة تمام الوضوح.
And it is 100% clear, absolutely clear, not ambiguous.
إنما المشركون نجس.
That the non-believers or the mushrikun are disgrace or a defile.
إنما المشركون نجس.
Yes, the infidels or the mushrikun are a defile.
فلا يقربوا المسجد الحرام.
And they should not go near or approach the holy mosque.
من المشرك النجس.
Who is this one? Who is a defiled and who is an unbeliever?
المشرك النجس هو فقط محرم عليه أن يقترب من المسجد الحرام.
Only this category of people who is not allowed to go there.
إذا جاء بابا الفاتيكان وقال أريد أن أطوف حول الكعبة.
If the Pope of the Vatican one day comes and says that I would like to go around the Kaaba.
ماذا يحصل؟
What will happen?
حسب ما هو ماشي الآن يقولون لا ممنوع.
According to the belief now, they say it is forbidden. You cannot do that.
يقول لنا لماذا؟
He would say, why? Why can't I do that?
اقنعوني.
Convince me. Give me evidence.
كيف نرد عليه؟
How can we argue with him? How can we answer him back?
سوف نبحث في القرآن كله ما نجدش إلا هذه الآية.
If we search in the Quran, we never find anything apart from this verse.
هذه الآية تقول إنما المشركون نجس.
This verse says only the atheists are defiled.
يرد عليك الباب ويقول لك أنا ماني مشرك وماني نجس.
The Bible, the Pope would say, I am not an atheist and I'm not being defiled.
إذن من حقي نطوف.
So I have the right to go around the Kaaba according to the verse of the Quran.
ويقول هذا بيت الله وضع لكل الناس.
This is the house of Allah that was constructed for everybody, for all mankind, and I have the right to go there.
يقول لك أنا مانيش مشرك أنا مؤمن بالله.
He would say that I am not an atheist and I believe in Allah. I am a believer.
وماني نجس.
And I am not defiled or I'm not.
تقدر وأنتم تقولوا له أنت يا بابا أنت نجس.
Can you say to him no? You are the contrary that you are defiled.
إذا جاء الرئيس الأمريكي وأراد أن يطوف على الكعبة ماذا تقولون له؟
And if the American president one day chooses to go to Kaaba, what would we say to him?
حسب ما هو يجري الآن هذا ممنوع.
According to the current belief now or the thoughts, it is forbidden. He's not allowed to do that.
يقول لنا لماذا تمنعوني؟
And he would say also, he would argue, why do you prevent me?
ماذا نقول له؟
What can we say to him in answering him back?
سوف نبحث في القرآن ما نجد أي شيء يمنعه.
We look into the Quran, we search in the Quran, and we don't find anything apart from this verse that I've just mentioned.
سوف نقول له أن هناك آية في القرآن.
We say to him that there is a verse in the Quran.
هي فقط تقول.
This verse, only this verse says the following.
إنما المشركون نجس فلا يقربوا المسجد الحرام.
Those people, the non-believers, the atheists, are defiled and are not supposed to be there.
ماذا يطرى بعد ذلك؟
What will happen after that?
أنت تقدر تقول للرئيس الأمريكي أنت مشرك ونجس؟
Can you say that to the American president that you are an atheist and you are?
اللي عنده إيمان وعنده شجاعة يعد يقولها للرئيس الأمريكي في وجهه يقول أنت نجس ومشرك. من حق ما تقربش المسجد الحرام.
Anyone who is brave enough, can he say that in the face of the American president that you are non-believers or an atheist and you are defiled and you cannot go around the Kaaba?
ولكن أؤكد لكم أنه لا يوجد من يستطيع أن يقول هذا للرئيس الأمريكي.
I assure you, no one can say that to the American president.
إذن الرئيس الأمريكي يقدر يطوف على الكعبة.
So the American president can go around the Kaaba.
يقول لك أنا مانيش نجس.
He would say, he would use the argument. He say, I'm not defiled according to the verse of the Quran.
أنت المسؤول عن شؤون الحج. تقدر تقول له أنت نجس.
Anyway, you are responsible for the affairs of pilgrimage. Can you say that to him?
بايك أنك راجع عاد تقول للرئيس الأمريكي قل له أنت نجس.
Okay, go to the American president and say that to him in his face that he is defiled.
ما يقدرش يقولها.
No one can say that. He cannot say.
وطوف على الكعبة غصبا عنك.
He can go around the Kaaba against your will.
من قال الرئيس الأمريكي مشرك؟ يقول لك أنا مانيش مشرك.
If you say to the American president that you are a non-believer or you're an atheist, he would say no. I don't believe in so many gods. I believe only.
يقول لك أنا مؤمن بالله.
He would say I believe in Allah. I believe in God.
كيف تقول لي مشرك؟
How come do you say that I am a non-believer or being a مشرك؟
هاي وهذا الموجود.
This is what is taking place right now.
اللي يجري الآن مخالف للقرآن.
What is going now is contrary to the Quran.
المشرك النجس لا يقرب المسجد الحرام فقط.
Only the atheist, the defiled, cannot go to the holy mosque according to the Quran.
أما بقية الناس كلها من حقها تطوف حول الكعبة.
The rest of the people have the right to go around the Kaaba.
واللي يمنعهم يعتبر كافر.
And anyone prevents them is considered a non-believer.
بصريح الآيات.
البينات في
القرآن according to the clear verses in the Quran.
إلا الذين كفروا ويصدون عن سبيل الله والمسجد الحرام.
Those who are non-believers and those who are
prevent
people from going from the holy mosque. These are the non-believers. These are the infidels.
لأن المسجد الحرام الله يقول الذي جعلناه للناس سواء.
Because Allah says in the Quran that the holy mosque is meant for everybody, for the whole mankind, for all peoples.
ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا. الناس كل الناس.
See, Allah says in the Quran, anyone who can go to the pilgrimage, he can do that. It is a speech meant to everybody.
ما قالش على العرب.
He never said that only Arabs can go to the pilgrimage or can do pilgrimage or Hajj.
ولله على الناس yes. الناس.
You see, Allah says الناس, which means all people. Human beings.
اللي يقدر يمشي للكعبة يمشي لها.
Anyone can go to Kaaba should do that. Can go that.
وإذ جعلنا البيت مثابة للناس ملتقى لكل البشر. Yes.
And also in the Quran we have made this Kaaba, this house, a rendezvous for everybody.
وأمنا.
A meeting place for everybody.
And اتخذوا مقام إبراهيم وصلى.
A safe haven, rendezvous for everybody.
واتخذوا من مقام إبراهيم مصلى للناس.
And also the talk to everybody to take or to make the place of Abraham a place for prayer.
وعهدنا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل أن طهرا بيتي للطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود.
And we have also instructed Abraham and his son Ismail to clean and make my house ready for anybody who wants to come and pray and go around it. And worship me.
يعني الله كلف إبراهيم وإسماعيل يجهزوا البيت أو يبنوا البيت.
This means Allah instructed Abraham and Ismail to make the house ready and to clean it and to make
it البيت
and to cleanse the house ready for prayer.
لكي تحج الناس في ذلك الوقت.
So people can go and do pilgrimage right from that time.
قبل محمد.
Before Muhammad.
يعني الناس هذا البيت الحرام معمول للناس.
Because this
holy
house or holy place was meant for everybody before Abraham, before Muhammad.
والله كلف إبراهيم قال وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق.
And also in the Quran says that. Once you call people to come for pilgrimage, people would come from all walks of life, either on foot or on horseback. They will come to do the pilgrimage, and this is a speech meant to everybody, to all mankind.
إن أول بيت وضع للناس للذي ببكة مبارك.
And the first house that was put or constructed is the house that is in Mecca, that is sacred and holy.
وهدى للعالمين.
And it is a guide to all mankind.
واضح جدا للناس.
It is very clear that it is meant to everybody.
وهدى للعالمين.
And it is a guide or a path to the whole mankind.
ناتي للموضوع الأخير. الذي ناتي الموضوع الأخير الذي يهمنا في هذا اليوم.
Now we come to the final issue or final subject that is of concern and importance to us on this great day.
نحن معنا هنا مسلمون من جميع أنحاء العالم.
Today we have Muslims from all over the world.
وأنا أعرف أن عدد كبير من المسلمين موجودين الآن معنا هنا. مضطهدين ومطاردين وحتى مكفرين من غيرهم.
And I know that a great number of Muslims who are celebrating today here with us are oppressed, suppressed, persecuted, being followed, and sometimes they even been labeled infidels.
نحن عندنا هنا طوائف ناس بيسموا أنفسهم
Shia, Sunnah.
We have people here, sects, they call, they name themselves Sunni, Shia.
والشيعه هذه طوائف.
And the Shia itself is divided into so many sects.
من ومنا ينكر أن الشيعة ليست مضطهدة.
Anyone of us can deny that the Shia is not being persecuted. How can anyone deny that? Or
الشيعة مضطهدين.
The Shiites are oppressed.
الأشراف مضطهدين.
And the أشراف also are oppressed and suppressed.
طوائف من الشيعة مكفرينها وطردوا فيها.
Shia sects are oppressed and followed and they have been labeled as being infidel and non-believers and
ظلما وعدوان.
And this is done against them in all injustice.
طوائف إسلامية معروفة تتعرض للاضطهاد.
يعني well-known Muslim or Islamic sects are being persecuted or oppressed and ill-treated.
أنا لا يهمني التفسير الديني للمشكلة.
I'm not really bothered about the religious explanation or interpretation of the problem.
يهمني الوضع السياسي لهذه الطوائف.
What is of my concern is the political situation of these sects.
للأسباب الدينية مهما كانت هناك اضطهاد سياسي لهذه الجماعات.
For any religious reasons, whatever they may be, there are political reasons for persecution or suppression against these sects.
الشيعي مواطن من الدرجة الثانية والثالثة في البلاد العربية.
Anyone who is Shi'i is a citizen of second class or third class in the Arab world, in the Arab countries.
إذن لكونه شيعي اضطهد سياسيا.
Just because he is Shia, he is being politically persecuted.
فقد حقه كمواطن من الدرجة الأولى مواطن عادي.
He lost his citizenship and he has become a citizen of second class just because being a Shia.
ما هو ذنبه إلا لأنه تشيع لآل البيت.
What is his fault? Just because he supported the family of the house or the of the prophet?
هذا السبب.
That's the reason.
الذين قالوا أن علي أولى بالخلافة أصبحوا شيعة.
Those people who have said that Ali had the right to become a caliph for the emir of the Muslims, they are Shiites.
البهرة الطائفة شيعية.
The Bahra is another Shiite sect.
مضطهدة ومشردة في أنحاء العالم.
It's also displaced all over the world and being wrongly oppressed.
البهائية طائفة شيعية مضطهدة ومكفرة ومطاردة.
The Baha'i sect is also a Shiite sect and it's also being wrongly oppressed and injustice being done against it and displaced all over the world.
النزارية طائفة شيعية مضطهدة ومشردة.
By the same token, the Nazarites also it's a sect and they are being oppressed.
الدروز نفس الشيء.
دروز, the same thing applies to them.
النصيرية نفس الشيء.
And Nasiri also the same thing.
الزيدية.
Zaydist also in the same category.
القاديانية.
And القاديانية also.
هذه كلها طوائف تندرج تحت الشيعة.
All these sects may come under Shia.
أنا ما يهمني في الخلافات الدينية اللي بينهم.
I'm not really bothered or I don't care that much about their religious differences.
أنا يهمني إن الأسباب الدينية ترتب اضطهاد سياسي على هذه الجماعات.
What is important to me is that because of the religious factors or reasons, persecution in the political aspect was done against them.
أنت شيعي ممنوع تكون رئيس للدولة هذه أو ملك لهذه الدولة.
You see, what happened is a political persecution. Just because you're a Shia, you cannot become a president. You cannot have this high-ranking position, for instance.
أنت من البهرة ممنوع تكون رئيس أو ملك.
You are from the Bahra or from the Baha'i. You are not allowed to become a president.
أنت درزي ممنوع تكون رئيس أو ملك.
you are being a Durzi, you cannot be a king, you cannot become a president.
انت بهائي ممنوع تكون رئيس ولا ملك.
Or you are from the Bahaya, you cannot become a king, you cannot become a president.
انت من الزيدية ممنوع كذلك.
Or by the same token, if you are from the Zaydi.
انت من الاشراف نفس الشيء.
Or from the Ashraf. Also, you are not supposed to be a king or a president or.
لأن الاشراف ينتمون إلى البيت النبوي الشريف.
Because the Ashraf belong to the house of the Prophet. May peace be upon him.
ولأن التشيع هو التشيع لأهل البيت.
Because التشيع or being a Shia is to support the followers of the bayt, of the family.
إذن الشيعة والإشراف كلهم مضطهدين
ومطاردين. So the Shia and the Ashraf, they're all oppressed, suppressed, not well treated.
الآن اللي نتكلم عليه ليس وضع ديني, وضع سياسي.
Now, what I'm talking is not a religious position. It is a political situation.
اضطهاد.
It's a persecution or oppression.
يتعلق بحقوق الإنسان.
Related to the human rights.
نحن بشر قبل لا تكون عندنا ديانة.
Before anything, before we adopt any faith or any religion, we are a human being.
نحن مواطنين في بلدنا قبل ما تكون عندنا ملل أو
and before anything, before we join any sects or any faiths, we are citizens in one country.
إذا نحن يجب أن نكون متساويين سياسيا.
So, politically speaking, we should be at on equal footing.
من عند الحق أنه هو يبعد هذا ويبعد هذا.
Who has the right to exclude this or exclude that?
الوطن للجميع.
The nation or the country belongs to all of us.
في هاي البلد أوغندا تاوي أعداد مضطهدة من البحر.
In this country, Uganda, many numbers of oppressed members of the Bahara living in Uganda.
من الإسماعيلية.
From the Ismailia.
الأغاخانية.
And from the Aghanism.
لماذا هم متشتتين من الهند إلى
Why are they displaced in India, in Uganda, dispersed?
هذا اضطهاد.
This is oppression.
هذا اضطهاد سياسي في النهاية.
This is in the end political oppression.
أنا خليني بيني وبين الله في الاعتقادات الدينية بتاعي.
Let it be the story between me and Allah as far as religion is concerned.
أما سياسيا نحن متساويين.
But politically we are equals.
مضبوط نعم 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 أنا إلى جانب المقهورين وجانب المضطهدين yes. من هذه الطوائف كل المضطهدة.
Yes, I stand beside the oppressed people and the suppressed people from all sects.
الإسماعيلية مشتتة في حال أرض الأربعة. أركان الأرض الأربعة.
And the Ismaili sects are dispersed in the all walks of life, in the four corners of life.
شكراً شكراً. في كل بلد في العالم تجد ناس خايفة مندسة
in every country
من هؤلاء يقولوا إسماعيليين زيديين شيعة شراف بهرة دروز نزارية نصيرية
from every world in the world you go and find community or a people afraid oppressed, suppressed, and if you ask where they are from the Ismailia, from the Bahaya, from the Zaydis, from Ashraf.
Qadianiyya, Bahaiyya.
Bahaiyya, or Qadianiyya.
يا أخي سيبك بينه وبين الله أنت مش ربه.
You are not God, you are not Allah. Leave him alone. Leave him between him and Allah. He knows how to deal with him.
أما تدعي أنك أنت بهذا السبب الديني تمنع من حقوقها السياسية وحقوقك كمواطن.
But because of this religious reasons or factors, you use it as a pretext and you prevent him from having political rights and deprive him of his political rights. It is not fair.
وبسبب هذا الاضطهاد. الذي تتعرض له هذه الطوائف.
And because of this oppression that such sects are facing,
كان لابد من الدعوة إلى إحياء الدولة الفاطمية الثانية.
There was a need to revive the revival of the second Fatimid empire or state.
لكي تحمي هذه الجماعات المضطهدة.
To protect these oppressed people or communities.
وقد تقوم الدولة الفاطمية من شمال أفريقيا إلى الشرق الأوسط.
And it may happen this Fatimid state in North Africa. It may be established one day.
ماذا لو قامت الدولة الفاطمية الثانية؟
What will happen if the second Fatimid state or empire will be
وأصبح الدولة قوية جدا.
And it will become a very powerful and strong nation or a country.
بعدين اللي يضطهدوا في هذه الطوائف يندمون يوم لا ينفع الندم.
Then they will, those people who are oppressing these sects will regret it one day.
هؤلاء الضعفاء قد تقوم لهم دولة في يوم ما.
Those weak people, one day they may have a country to protect.
دولة البهائيين والقاديانيين والإسماعيليين والزيديين والبهرة والشيعة والنصيريين والدروز، كل هؤلاء الطوائف المضطهدة قد تقوم لهم دولة في يوم ما.
All these sects who are oppressed, one day they may have a country of their own, a country of the Druze, a country of the Bahaya, a country of the Zaydis, a country of the Ashraf, and etc.
هذه قضية تخص حياتنا.
This is an issue that is of concern to us. It is to do with our own life.
ما هيش مسألة نقاش فلسفي أو تاريخي قديم.
It is not a matter of discussion based on philosophy or religion or history or.
لا نحن نتكلم عن ال. وضع سياسي.
No, we are talking about a political situation that we are facing.
في كل عام إن شاء الله نحيي هذا اليوم العظيم.
Every day, inshallah, every year, inshallah, we commemorate and celebrate this great day.
جيلا بعد جيل.
Generation after generation.
حتى ينتصر دين الله الحق.
Till the faith of Allah will be rightly victorious on earth.
ويتأكد أن محمد هو رسول نبي للناس كافة.
And it will be proved and vindicated that the Prophet Muhammad is the Prophet of all mankind.
وأن الدين عند الله الإسلام.
And that the faith of Allah is Islam.
كل سنة وانتم طيبين. السلام عليكم.
Congratulations. May peace be upon you.